I find it incredible that scientists can look at a skull, just the skull, and determine almost exactly who that person was. Skulls hold clues to our race, age, and sex. For example, just from a skull found in the woods in 1988, police were able to solve the case of a young Asian woman whose husband was ultimately charged with her murder. You probably know we all have fingerprints, but no two persons' prints are the same. Skulls are like this too. Every individual's skull is different. Your parents determine how your skull is shaped, but your ancestry helps scientists identify where you came from and who you are. Our skulls underlie how we look. Things like the height of our cheekbones and the shape of our jaw determine our facial features, but those don't necessarily help solve cases. They're called non-metric features, and they're just too personal. But there are some general features all skulls have that help identify who a skull belonged to. One of the first questions anyone would have looking at a solitary skull is whether it came from a man or a woman. Men tend to have larger, thicker, heavier skulls with a more pronounced ridge here, in their temporal line, and a more pronounced ridge over the top of the eyes. Women have a slightly sharper surface on the edge of their eye socket. Skulls hold clues to age as well. The bones that make up the skull are separated in babies but held together by fibrous bands of tissue that allow the brain to grow. These are unique fibrous joints called cranial sutures. As we age, the bones grow closer together and the joints start to fuse. The older we get, the more the sutures close. I'm sure someone is already down in the comments asking about race. Yes, skulls can reveal a lot about our race as well, but like with any of these other characteristics, they're not 100%. In fact, often skulls seem to indicate they come from more than one racial group. Humans have evolved different features over time as we've adapted to different environments, and our skulls show those clues to our ancestry. Take the nose, for example, the nasal spine, the little bit of bone that supports the cartilage separating the nostrils. In Asian populations, that bone tends to be of moderate height. In Caucasian populations, it's more prominent and straighter. In African populations, it's significantly smaller or sometimes totally absent. And shapes of noses differ too, anthropologists think, because of the climates we evolved in, and this is reflected in the shape and size of the nasal cavities. Populations in the cooler climates of Europe adapted by forming narrower noses to more efficiently heat inhaled air, while populations in warmer climates like Africa adapted with broader noses. And there are other distinguishing factors as well. An oval-shaped window in the inner ear is seen more in Caucasian populations than Native American populations. There are also subtle differences between populations in the shape of eye orbits, projection of the lower jaw and forehead, the shape and distance between cheekbones, and the shape of the forehead. There is so much you can learn from looking at the big bone that makes up your face. Of course, studying a skull alone isn't perfect. The case of the murdered woman hinged on the skull, but also involved routine police work and facial reconstruction. But in any case, knowing a victim's sex, age, and possible heritage can absolutely help narrow down the search and find a killer. Special thanks to our sponsor, Domain.com. When you buy a domain from Domain.com, you're taking the first steps in creating an identity and vision for your brand. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. Get 15% off Domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use coupon code SEEKER at checkout. Of course, there's so much more to forensic science, like DNA evidence, which isn't always right, as Trace explains in this video right here. But seriously, how cool is this? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Be sure to give this video a like and subscribe so you never miss an episode of SEEKER.